It's been a long time since I've seen a crypto mining safety video, and it's been an even longer time since I've seen anything negative said about Octominer, but unfortunately, these photos right here are from about a week ago from a local mining friend, and this is a first generation Octominer X12 with 140mm Ventus Max fans manufactured July of 2021, and as you can see, there was a fire. It took a little while to figure out exactly where the fire originated, but it turns out it was fan number 5, so the fan furthest away from the controller, and we don't exactly know why, but the fan did fail in such a manner where it started overdrawing on the power, and unfortunately the fan controller boards in Octominers are not fused. So this fan was able to, as it was failing, draw, in my speculation, probably 4 or 5 times as much power as it was rated for. Luckily, this fire happened about 5 minutes after the rig booted for its time of day mining, and he was around, so he was able to catch it and use a fire extinguisher on it. However, it's worrying because there was another fan number 2 in this rig, that had not failed yet, but it was starting to bubble on the wire in the exact same way. So I'm not exactly sure if we are going to bench test that other failing fan. I know for sure he has emailed Octominer just asking for clarification to see if they have any other reports in the past of these first generation X12 and X8 fans failing in this manner. I know you guys probably remember that Red Panda mining video from a year or two ago, right when he started getting his first Octominers, where almost every fan was dying. But when they died, they simply stopped rotating. I couldn't find any record searching online of Octominer fans failing in this manner. But it's very, very clear that the fault started with a failing Octominer Ventus Max fan, and it's got us all kind of spooked, even to the point where we're not even considering buying new Ventus fans from Octominer until we have a little bit more clarity, because although this failure was stopped, had he not been home, this could have turned into a really pretty significant house fire. You won't believe it, though. Every single one of these graphics cards still works. He was able to extract the PCIe power pins and put them back into the Octominer one by one, and they all mined just fine. So it was not a GPU issue. We do have some statistics from HiveOS as this was failing. However, nothing very conclusive, just due to the sampling interval of the HiveOS software. Unfortunately, although these GPUs have a new kind of artistic vibe to them, most of them are damaged to the point where they're probably no good for resale anymore. I did mention that they all survived. Even the fans all still work. So, props to the GPU manufacturers, even Zotac and Gigabyte, for making such durable pieces of equipment. This Gigabyte Eagle 3080 Ti was closest to the fire. This 3070 FTW3 was a little bit further away. But in the mix also were 2 XC cards and an ASUS Phoenix card, as well as a Ventus X3 shown here. So this is just super scary. This was only about a minute worth of fire after the wiring auto-ignited underneath fan number 5. And again, had he not been home to catch this, had his dogs not barked at the smell of smoke, this may have ended in a very, very different way. So, although this is maybe limited to early fans in a single batch of Octominers, it's worth putting together just to warn you guys to always be as careful as you possibly can be when you're crypto mining. Even if you're not using Octominers, I'll touch on splitters and other fire mitigation methods here in just a couple of minutes when I switch into the stream OBS mode. But here's a couple more photos in the meantime. It's kind of beautiful, but also insanely scary at the same time. I was actually a little bit surprised he was able to extract the PCIe connectors from these GPUs. I've had a couple instances where the connectors have not been fully plugged in on cards that I've purchased, and I've pretty much had to solder new PCIe connectors onto the PCBs, but you can see the cards, even the Ventus, he was able to save the fan from that melted shroud amazingly. But again, chalk one up to, it's unbelievable how durable hardware actually is. I was amazed when these all got plugged back in, especially, again, the power connections. Anyway, here finally we can see the fan wiring. So you can see the red and black, which are the positive and negative. The other ones are just TAC and then PWM input signal. But you can see these are 22 gauge copper wires, and they go straight from the fan PWM controller on the hub over to the Octominer fan controller. And with active airflow, these fans were running at 60% static speed in a 90 degree Fahrenheit environment. That's a lot of power to melt through cable jacketing like that. This is the actual failed fan. The top of the image here is the bottom of the fan in the case. But you can see the hub is fine. So this actually did not originate from the fan hub. This happened further down in a hotter spot where, you know, there was more limited airflow. But this did not take long to ignite. Fire spreads incredibly fast. High glass fiber reinforced plastic tends to burn. It doesn't tend to melt. So I'm not actually sure the GF content of these fans. I can only assume that they're glass fiber reinforced ABS. But as you can tell, these things are incredibly screwed. So here we go. This is the fan controller. It shows fan number 5 and then also fan number 2. Fan number 2 had not failed yet. There were no issues on the backplane, so we really didn't suspect anything crazy there. Fan 2, again, was very, very close behind. You can see kind of the topology of the failure on the inside of the lid here. Thank you very much to, I don't think he wants to be named, but the local friend for marking up these photos, just so you guys can get a better idea of how this actually progressed. It was nice to be able to clearly identify the failure origin. And we were all kind of surprised that it was a fan. And not only a fan, but the wiring to the fan and something that was operating completely within specification. It was that 3070 Ti that you guys saw before. So here is the other fan, the one that did not catch on fire yet. You can see this one is not Aventus Max, it's just Aventus. So that's a little bit more concerning. I was hoping to just tie it to a certain model of fan, because I had not seen Aventus Max fan before in any of my Octominers, and I do have a couple of first gen Octominers. This is the hub on the fan that actually let go. So you can see it says Aventus Max. Same specifications, same verbiage, same, you know, motor layout, same bearing layout, everything like that. So again, we really don't have any closure. We don't have any information as to why this let go, which is all the more scary.
Hey guys, so after that little voiceover with the slideshow, I'm going to be showing you a couple of the same images, but a couple of new things, as well as a few visual aids just about general rig safety. But I do have a thought about how to potentially remedy that. I don't know if that failure was due to a bad batch of fans, or if it was due to a lack of fusing, or, you know, exactly what. But I do have an Octominer control board right here. And it does have a 6-pin power input, so just a PCIe power input. And on this board, there's no mechanical means of fusing. So each one of those fan headers would be allowed at any time to draw as much as this 6-pin would put out. And in the case of an Octominer, that goes to a backplane on somewhere between 3,000 and 6,000 watts of power supply. So I do think incorporating some inline fuses that are maybe rated for 3 amps, just whatever is above the rating of your fan, in this case the Aventus Max fans that failed in this Octominer X12, are rated at about 25 watts apiece, so 2.1 amps. I think that would be a good peace of mind function, but man, the failure is just unreal on this. The fact that it was an X12, the fans were 2 years old already, they were running at 60% fan, the ambient temperature was low, and the fact that it just auto-ignited the fiberglass reinforced fan and most of the GPUs within under this wooden shelf without doing any permanent damage. You gotta thank dogs for that one. So anyway, this is the actual fan that failed. It's Aventus Max, produced in July of 2021. I need to go check all of my Octominers, but most of them are just Ventus, not Aventus Max. All of the specs are exactly the same between the two, so I don't know what's going on there. But I feel a little uneasy now having anything Octominer in my rigs, fans specifically. You can see here the photo of the, it's the exact same board. It's a Gen 1 X12 board, the same thing I have here. And you can see these got hot. So these little fan headers, one of them was the actual auto-igniting wire, which we'll look at in a second. And the other one was a fan that had almost done the same thing. So still potentially going to, in a controlled environment, let that fan auto-ignite and see exactly what happens, measure how much power it's drawing. But I would wager, just by the 22-gauge wire that these fans run on, the fact that that thing melted the jacketing off of it with a pretty high airflow environment, that it was probably between 70 and 100 watts on just that one fan. So we still don't exactly know why that fan decided to draw way too much power. My speculation, which is potentially completely wrong, is that the bearing started to fail on that fan and the PWM controller was trying to reach a certain fan speed. And I'm guessing it was pushing more and more current through it to try to reach that fan speed, and that probably burned out the controller. I don't know. If the controller fused to full on, that could cause this. But anyway, this sort of bubbling on that positive and negative wire, I mean, it's only 22 gauge, but as far as I know, it's copper, and that can handle a lot of current when it's air-cooled. So very, very worrying that a fan rated for 25 watts could potentially draw way more than that. Here is the actual fan that failed. So it looks like the actual cable outside of the fan hub started, not the fan hub itself. I don't know, but it got me thinking. I originally saw these fireballs in a hobbyist miner video, and they're not a surefire thing, no pun intended, but I have bought a slew of these, and my plan is to put them, you know, they detonate on open flame, not on heat, so I'm going to get them as close to my rigs as I possibly can, because I'd rather clean up this ABC filth than have a fire on my hands. So they've gotten a lot cheaper over the last year. I thought this was cheap enough insurance. I'm not affiliated with any of these stores, but I will include affiliate links down below. So anyway, if you click on them, I do get a percentage of that. I want to talk splitters after that. So I think I brought up, yeah, these garbage splitters. So anytime you see a 6-pin to twin eights with just this ketchup and, well, I guess just mustard, just assume that these are all 22 gauge wire. I would recommend not using these at all, but if you're going to use them, only do it on very, very low power cards, like a 1060 or a 1660, and only for the risers. Still, I wouldn't recommend any splitter that is 22 gauge. We have independently tested a lot of these by cutting them apart, and we found that most of these wrapped 8-pin to dual 8-pin splitters are actually 18 gauge. So that's these right here. Sellers may vary. I will actually grab an order, a brand on Amazon that I bought from before that I'm pretty confident are 18 gauge, and I'll post that too. But splitters are a really, really big thing. Keep in mind, this fire didn't happen because of splitters. It happened because of fans. So we still don't have really any word as to why this happened. I know the early X8 and X12 Octominers had tons of fan failures, but they, as far as I know, just burned out and stopped working. So this is the first time I've actually heard of a fire happening based on one of those controllers failing, but it's still really good safety practice to have thick wire gauge in your splitters. Another really good one if you need 6-pin to dual 8 is the Deep in the Mine splitters, and there are situations where you need this. So a lot of like the EVGA power supplies, the actual daisy chain lead is a 6-pin, and that's a beefy cable. So typically I'd feel pretty comfortable. These are 18 gauge as well. These are good. We've worked with a lot of these. But yeah, just stay away from anything that might be 22 gauge, and never ever use these. Yours might be yellow and black, but the SATA to 6-pin for the riser, don't use them. Don't use Molex. It's not worth it. So that's really kind of the 1,000-foot view, 10,000-foot view even, of the DC side of the rig. So make sure all that is taken care of. Never run fans on multiple fans on a Molex. Never run multiple fans on a SATA. One here and there is fine, but like, do try to use dedicated fan controllers. Do try to use fan headers on motherboards. Typically, I don't like to run fans full tilt just because they get hot, but you know, this failure wasn't at 100%, so I don't even know what to tell you there. As far as powering the rig, make sure you never use a power strip. Anytime you're on 120 volt, make sure you're running at least a 14 gauge thickness or thicker, so 14, 12. Don't run the 18 gauge or the 22 gauge garbage that a lot of these come with, because a lot of the Chinese cases and things like that, although they support 120 volts, the cable is actually rated in size for 240 volts, because how current and voltage works, you can pass twice as much wattage through a same conductor gauge in 240 volts as you can in 120 volts. Picture it like two lanes of highway traffic versus one. You can pass, actually that's a bad analogy because it'd be twice as wide, but think of 120 mile an hour speed limit versus a 60 mile an hour speed limit. You can get twice as many cars through and that same conductor in the same amount of time. So anyway, that's wattage versus amperage. I'll digress there. 220, it's not nearly as big of a deal necessarily, but never overload your circuits. Get a meter. Never leave the meter on the rig while you're actually mining with it. Stay under 80% of the rated circuit current. Even if it's a shared circuit between other outlets, make sure that entire circuit is beneath the 80% rule. It's just not worth the fire risk. And this failure right here has my entire local mining crew petrified. Because this is the... Okay, you think of what's the highest quality mining equipment you can buy. The set it and forget it solution. It's an Octominer. And what failed? What nearly burned this man's house down? An Octominer. So really just taking as much care as possible. That's why we're all getting these fire suppression balls. There's a lot of other solutions, never coil cords. Again, make sure you're staying under the circuit protection rating. Get smoke detectors, things like the Nest smoke detector. You can link them together, so even if you have mining in your garage or something, if there's a fire, if there's smoke, it will alarm the one next to your bedroom. Make sure you have fire extinguishers, real ones, next to your rig. Just be careful, guys. So none of this is safety advice. Consult with actual people that do safety, you know, fire training for a job, but like just helpful pointers and things that we've done for ourselves to try to save us from getting burned down by something like this. It just was unbelievable to see an Octominer do this.